What's up, everyone? I'm Joe from Within the Ruins. We're doing some pre-production stuff here at my house. Headed to the studio this week to record a little EP, so we figured we'd show you guys some stuff. Let's go check out what these guys are doing. Yeah, you guys are good.
Yeah, thanks.
Feels good with that shit.
Good
filming.
Thanks.
Rooms.
So, it's good.
I think we're ready for some studio.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's good.
I'm definitely ready for some Josh Whitman in my life. So, this is drummer from Nether Ruins. Just wanted to give you a little tutorial about stuff that I need to perform. Starting with that center block right there. That's so this bad boy doesn't move out of place. Notice how great that is. That must be 10 years old. But then we got the other center block right here. Don't mind this taped up broken cymbal stand. That holds that in place because I hit that so hard it moves sometimes. And this right here is about to fall off. So that's the essential shit that I need to play well. So here you go.
Sick.
It's supposed to go again, but the reason why that part is so fucked up is because I did a bad copy and paste and on a different time signature, so it just came out wrong, and I was like, well, that's kind of sick.
That's kind of sick.
That's kind of sick.
I'm just gonna go over a few things that are really essential for getting that tone, that metal tone that we get. We'll start, the Mesa cab's not really that important. You can use whatever cab. What you wanna do is get a few CD boxes, two preferably. Two, it seems like it's just perfect height, two boxes. So you just stack them. I'm just doing a simple stack. And then we got I think this is a SM58 mic, which is for vocals really, I think. But for the tone we're going for, this is what you really want to use. And to keep it, the whole stand is, this is green painter's tape, which keeps it where you want it. And from there, it comes over here. And so this little Mackie doozy guy I got here, a little mixing station, I throw it right in there and then I run it up into the shit right here. This is the motherboard. This is where all the shit comes from. I mean, this is the Dell 1705.
Dell Inspiron.
This is a 2002 model. And it's been on since 2002 for the most part. This is what you want to finish getting that tone when doing stuff like this. So that's it. That's pretty much it.
Yep. That's about it. None of this has anything to do with it.
No, you don't need anything else. None of that. Except for boxes and
just,
old computer.
It's this and that.
And this.
And that.
This is a garage, is where we practice. One thing that really helps us practice and get really tight so we can play really good live is this foam on the wall here that just isn't really connected. It just makes it really soundproof.
That has a lot to do with the tone, right?
A lot of tone. escapes through a regular wall like that, the plain wall, you lose a lot of tone. Make sure that you play with an empty space in your rack that usually has your main head. Play with your backup head only. That's important. Also, have a shitload of cardboard boxes behind everything because that really brings out the acoustics of the room, an old drum set, and a bunch of bullshit. Really make you sound sick. And chairs are essential for getting the proper stance during practice because you can't just stand, that's boring.